Thankfully, no ill effects from that storm system here in Central Florida.
I tell you what, the story for us this week is going to be heat and dryness. There may be a few isolated showers and storms tomorrow. We'll break that down, Jim and Martha, straight ahead. Let me take you back outside. If you were working out there today, you certainly felt it, the heat. Afternoon highs downtown Orlando, at least on the hour anyway, 88 degrees. But when you factor in the humidity, it certainly felt like a 90 degrees plus today. As we switch gears here, head a little bit farther south and west into Lake County. Pretty looking shot right there. Now, the interesting thing today as we take a look at the satellite and radar is that there have been some showers and some thunderstorms that developed right around Lake Okeechobee, and some of that moisture actually crept up into southern Brevard and Osceola County. Now, the question for tomorrow is, will there be enough moisture to produce some isolated showers and thunderstorms here in Central Florida? I think the answer is going to be yes. Don't think it's going to move it into Orlando, but I wanted to show you just how far north we have some showers right now. Here's the Polk Osceola County line. There's Kenansville. We had a couple of showers and storms in and around Palm Bay and Point South. So with a little more energy tomorrow and a little bit more heating, some of that has the risk and chance for making it on up into southern Sumter and Lake County and on south and west of Orlando. So we'll have to watch that and the heat now. Afternoon highs tomorrow running close to 90 degrees in many locales. And when you factor in the heat and humidity, this is the time of the year where your body's adjusting to the heat and where you kind of forget, because we're coming out of the spring and those cooler temperatures, to drink the water. So we would certainly urge you to do that. You can see the wind's kind of chaotic. But the hour by hour right through midnight, not a cool night by any standards tonight, 71 degrees at midnight, 66 in the morning. Average lows this time of the year should be running right around 60 degrees, so we're going to be running about 5 to 7 degrees above average on that end of things. We head through the afternoon tomorrow. There's that big dome of high pressure, the Bermuda High, east-southeasterly winds. Note the moisture here pooling north and west, so that's one of the things that we're going to watch throughout the afternoon. This particular computer model hinting at it late in the afternoon, so we're going to put about a 20% chance for some showers south and west of Orlando. Kissimmee will put you in there. Claremont, Winter Haven, you as well will be included in that 20% chance. And along the coast, southeast winds 15 to 20 gusting by late afternoon, and the swells running about 2 to 3 feet. Rip currents are going to be concerned as we head into the upcoming weekend. The hour by hour now for tomorrow, 69. 84 and 89. Watch the afternoon heat. A few isolated storms. Not much better. Lots of heat there on Wednesday. Jim and Martha, as we look ahead now towards Thursday, Friday, and Saturday here, you're going to see pretty much hot and dry. The weekend forecast for Easter looking sizzling for the Bunny.